What's hopping, guys? Isaac Hayes here at DLife HD. Today we're going to be discussing the hand-drawn boss shoot-a-thon, Cuphead. Switch. This title was released on Xbox One in 2017, and only recently launched on the Nintendo Switch at the end of last month. First, let's talk about the core game modes. This game is centered around the story element that Cuphead and his pal Mugman have fallen into debt with the devil himself, and the only way to free themselves is by hunting down the devil's enemies. With that being said, most of what makes up the gameplay is simple. You have a map view, you select a level, most of which are boss fights. Then you do your best to knock out your foe. Next is controls and gameplay. This game has a few different unique elements. Every level is one of three things: boss fights, running guns, and aerial combat levels. The main combat is progressed through knocking health out of your enemies by using the main pea shooter weapon or charging up your special move. This is charged over time or by attacking. Through the boss fights, they change form and abilities to spice up the gameplay and challenge the consumer one step at a time. Another useful concept is that of the item shop. Here, you can purchase health boosts and upgrades that will affect the way your weapon fires. Now, on to the UI and graphics. The UI is very simple, and there is not much to be said here. But I would like to point out two special things. One, it is easier to switch between co-op and solo player modes. This is very handy. And two, after being defeated in a level, there is a progress bar displayed. This is very, very useful, as it shows what stage of the fight you have achieved and how close you were to the next stage. Although, this has angered me a few times, seeing how close I was to completing the fight. The graphics are completely hand-drawn and look perfect. I personally cannot critique it for its visuals in any way, shape, or form. Up next on the list is music and sound.
And now they're fighting for their lives on a mission fraught with dread.
From the opening barbershop quartet on the main menu to the intense jazz cymbals and trumpets, this game's music is amazing. Note, you will find yourself hearing the beginnings of these songs because you will start these levels over a lot. The general audio of the game is just so fun and engaging. I love the announcer, how he shouts out nonsense through a loudspeaker at the beginning of each level. Lastly, I'd like to discuss the story. As I mentioned before, Cuphead and his pal Mugman are in a serious debt. It will cost them their lives if they don't defeat the devil's betrayers. This loose-fitting story makes the game feel urgent to the player, and really adds to the atmosphere. Aside from that, the core of this game is its aesthetic, not its story. So that wraps that up. In closing, because of its art, music, and resemblance of 30s-era cartoons, there is a major appeal to me personally. I have a great deal of nostalgia for that era. I would also like to point out that this game is a perfect port. That's not something we see every day on the Switch. But, because it is solely hand-drawn, there is no need to push pixels like big games. In fact, everything about this game is almost identical to the Xbox version, making it perfect. With all of this being said, I believe it's time to give this game a rating. Now, I hate to be super generous on my first rating on the channel, but I have no way to refuse a 5-star rating for Cuphead. It's perfect. It's music, it's art, it's resemblance of the 30s-era cartoons, it's gameplay, it's difficulty level, and appeal to average gamers. It is a perfect, perfect game. Alright everybody, thank you for joining me. Let me know in the comments below if you agree with me, or my opinions, or have one to share of your own. If you like this video, be sure and smash that like button, because it really helps us out a lot. If you want more content like this, remember to subscribe, because we release Switch content pretty regularly. Also, follow us on Twitter and Facebook for more game updates. I would also like to point out that if you enjoy hearing my voice, be sure and check it out in podcast form on my podcast, The Nintendo Bros Podcast. You can find it on Spotify and even on the Anchor app. And lastly, remember, always stay one up.